friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. Today we just going to see projection of planes. In this topic, today we going to see the rectangular plane. And initially I will be explaining the question and I will be explaining how to get the given data. And finally we will be telling step by step procedure. A rectangular plane 70 mm into 40 mm. So the first of all we just want to identify what kind of base data we going to draw. In our case it's a rectangle. The rectangle will be having a long ridge as 70 mm and short ridge as 40 mm. One of its short ridges in the BP. Then we need to see where it is resting. So they have clearly given that it's resting on BP. So resting will be BP. BP, it's a short ridge. We have to check whether there are two types of rectangle, right? Once we can draw like this. This one will be long ridge and this one will be the short ridge. So one and two. So these are the two types of diagram which we can draw. So this one will be the long ridge and this one will be short ridge. In our case, we are going to take only second diagram because they have clearly mentioned it's a shorter ridge. Then it's 40 degree, inclined at 40 degree HP. So we are just going to incline the rectangle, incline the surface to 40 degree HP. Draw the top view. If front view is a square setting, if front view is a square of side 40 mm. So what they are telling is, just see here. Just consider this as a rectangle. So when you are seeing from the front, we will be drawing like this. This one will be short ridge and this one will be long ridge. Short ridge will be resting on the BP. So initially we will be drawing the front view. So initial diagram we will be drawing the rectangle here and the rectangle can be a short ridge. Short ridge will be lying on BP. But when it is inclined 40 degree to HP, so when we are inclining 40 degree means here we will be getting the square. So when the rectangle is inclined to some angle, what happens is when we see from here, we can see a square form. So we can clearly see a square form. So same thing we just going to draw, I will be explaining step by step. First step is we just going to draw the front view because the rectangle will be seeing only from the BP. So when it's seeing from BP, when the rectangle is lying on BP means when you are seeing from the front, you can see only the front view. From the front view only we can get the true shape of the diagram and base diagram will be a rectangle. Since they are given the short ridge, then we have to go with the second diagram. So we will be taking the short ridge. The short ridge length is 40 mm and long ridge length is 70 mm. So we can draw the rectangle and naming we can give us 1, 2, 1-, 2-, 3-, 4-, even A-, B-, C-, D- also can be given. Next we are going to see the top view. When you seeing the rectangle from the top, we can see only the line. Only line can be seen. 1 can be seen but 2 can't be seen. 4 can be seen, 3 can't be seen. So when you are writing, we can write 1 and bracket 2. When you are seeing from top, we can see 4 but we can't see 3. So top view is a line. So when we are seeing from top, we can see 1 and we can see 2. So that's why I am writing as 1 and bracket 2. 2 will be hidden. Same thing here also. 4th point we can see, 3rd point we can see. So that's why we are writing 3rd in the hidden. So this is a straight line and this line will be lying on the reference line itself. Next thing is they have given a hint. The front view, when you are seeing the front view, will be seen as a square. So what I am going to do, you just try to keep your scale. Keep your scale as it is on the 4-dash point and try to draw a line. The length of this line is 40 mm because they have clearly given that the square of side is 40 mm. So the length of this line will be 40 mm and all the sides will be equal. So 40, 40, 40, 40. All the sides will be equal and naming can be written as if it's 1- means you can write as 1-1-. If it's 2- means you can write 2-1-. Likewise we can complete it. So we got this square with reference to previous diagram. Now what we are going to do, we just going to extend this. See here, if you just extend this line to some extent and try to extend this line to some extent, we know the distance of this line, just keep the line as it is. For example, if the line length is 5 cm means, just take your scale, measure this length of the line and keep the line as it is so that it will be fitting between these two lines and then we can identify the angle. Just measure this line and keep as it is, or else you just measure this line, take your compass, measure this line, keep your compass here and try to cut down this extended line. After cutting it, you can rub the unwanted line. These lines are not unwanted, right? So you can rub it up. Next thing is what we are going to do is we just going to draw the we just going to incline this line for 40 degree. Now just draw this line. So they have clearly given that it's inclined 40 degree to HP. So just draw the line for 40 degree with reference to reference axis. On this line we can keep the side. They have clearly said that the edges are going to be inclined. That is the shorter edge is inclined at 40 degree to HP. So this is the shorter edge. This is the shorter edge. I'm just going to incline the shorter edge to 40 degree. So 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2 will be here. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to extend all the four corners vertically, as well as I will be extending this horizontally, and then will be identifying the four points. Now I'm just extended all the four corners. So these are the four corners, just extended vertically downwards. And already we are having one corner on the reference line, so no problem. We are having the second corner. Just extend the second corner horizontally. Just try to identify all the four points. For example, this 1, 2 and this 1, 1 will be meeting at one point, and mark that point. This 2 and this 2 will be meeting at one point, mark that point. And this 3 and this 3 will be intersecting at one point, mark that point as 3. Same way for 4. Now we have identified all the four corners. Just join all the four corners. So we will be getting a rectangle shape, and try to rub the unwanted lines. After completing the entire diagram, just go for dimensioning. For dimensioning, we can dimension the shorter edge, so 40 mm. These are the extension line. Extension line should be very, very thin. It can be drawn with your 2H pencil. And extension line should be 1 mm away from the diagram. These are the dimensioning line. Dimension line can be drawn with your H pencil. See to it that the number should be vertical and it should be placed between the lines. And this is the longer edge. Longer edge is 70 mm. And here it's the shorter edge, so square we drawn right. So we have to dimension 40 mm, and angle, just measure the angle. Just measure whatever angle you are getting. Right now I don't have the answer. Just measure the angle and write whatever angle you are getting here. And this one they have clearly given the question 40 degree. And height of the text. So heading will be projection of rectangular plate. Height of the text should be 10 mm. And this is the subheading. So all dimensions are in mm, scale 1:1. The height of the text for both should be 5 mm. And see to it that you should draw very neatly and try to rub the unwanted lines. So these lines are all unwanted. Try to rub it so the diagram will be looking good. In case if you have any doubt, means you can ask in the comment section. If you feel this video is useful, means then kindly share it with your first year students. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.